So again, we will see what is the mechanical construction of the curve. X square is equal to 4ay. So similarly here you see, for any negative value of y, for any negative value of y, for y to be negative, for y to be negative, we are getting that x square is equal to 4a, where we know that a is always greater than 0. So this is positive into negative, the entire quantity 4ay will be negative for any negative value of y. So if x square is negative, then x is equal to square root of negative quantity, which is an imaginary quantity. So since for y to be any negative quantity, we get x to be imaginary, that's why the entire part of the curve y square is equal, x square is equal to 4ay, will just lie to above the x-axis. It will not come to the below the x-axis, because it of the reason that for any negative value of y, x square becomes imaginary. So the entire part of the curve will be lying just above the x-axis. It will not come below the x-axis. Again, for any positive value of x, for any positive value of x, so x square will be positive. That implies that x will be square root of positive quantity, which is a real quantity, which is a real number. So here you see that for y is equal to a, for y is equal to a, this distance is a. So for y is equal to a, we are getting that x square is equal to 4a square. So x square is equal to 4a square implies that x is equal to plus minus 2a. That means for every positive value of y, there will be two values of x which are equal in magnitude, which are equal in magnitude but opposite in sign. That means the curve x square is equal to 4ay is just symmetrical about the y axis. That means SL distance is equal to L dash S distance. So what for a y is equal to this point is focus. Focus is 0a, which is lying on the y axis. For y is equal to a, we are getting two values of x. One is plus 2a, another is minus 2a. So this point is your 2aa, and this point is minus 2aa. So again, when y tends towards infinity, that means y increases infinitely, x will increase. X increases infinitely and x decreases infinitely. That means this curve, when y tends towards infinity, there will be two values of x. One value of x will tend towards plus infinity and another will tend towards minus infinity. So this is the mechanical construction of the curve x square is equal to 4ay. That means x square is equal to 4ay, which is lying in the second and the third quadrant. The entire part of this curve is lying in the second and the third quadrant. So next we will consider what are the coordinates of the vertex, focus, endpoints of lateral septum and all other things. So here you see that the equation of the curve is x square is equal to 4ay. X square is equal to 4ay. So first point is your, that is, what is the coordinates of the vertex? Coordinates of the vertex. So vertex is nothing but that is 0, 0. So coordinates of the vertex is 0, 0. Second point is, what is the coordinates of the focus? Which point is the focus? Focus is S. S point coordinates are 0, A. 0, A. Third is, What is the endpoints of the later septum? Endpoints of the later septum. Endpoints of later septum LR. That is equal to plus minus 2A. Plus minus 2A. Fourth point. What is the length of the later septum? Length of LR. Length of LR, that is the length of later septum, is LSL dash. That is equal to LSL dash, which is equal to twice of LS. And LS is 2A. So it is twice of 2A. That is equal to 4A. Now, fifth point. The equation of the directrix. So directrix here, directrix is a line parallel to x-axis and cutting y-axis at a distance a from the negative direction of y-axis. So what will be its equation? Its equation will be equal to y is equal to minus a. So equation of the directrix is y is equal to minus a. Sixth point. So here we know that the line joining the vertex to the focus is called the axis of the parabola. So OS line is the axis of the parabola, which is the y-axis, and its equation is x is equal to 0. So equation of the axis is y is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. Extremely sorry. It is x is equal to 0. Now last point is your seventh point. Equation of later septum. Later septum is a line parallel to x-axis and cutting y-axis at a distance a. So the equation is y is equal to a. So you just similarly you remember these 7 points of the parabola x square is equal to 4ay. So again we will consider the mechanical construction of the curve x square is equal to minus 4ay, where your a is greater than 0. Now for any positive value of y, x square becomes negative. For y to be positive, we are similarly getting that x square is equal to negative. So that implies that x becomes imaginary, square root of negative. It is imaginary. So that means the curve, entire part of the curve, x square is equal to minus 4y, will lie below the x-axis. It cannot lie above the x-axis, because for any positive value of y, x becomes imaginary. Now again you see that for every negative value of y, x square becomes positive. This implies that x is square root of positive, that is a real quantity, that is a real number. So for every negative value of y, that means for here you see that for y is equal to this distance is a, so this point is your 0 minus a. So when y is equal to minus a, we are getting that x square is equal to 4a square. That implies that x is equal to plus minus 2a. That means for every negative value of y, x will have two values which are equal in magnitude, opposite in sign. That means for y is equal to minus a, there will be two values of x. One is plus 2a, another is minus 2a. So this point L point is 2a minus a, and this point is here 2a minus a.
So these are the endpoints of the later septum, because this is the focus and later septum is the double ordinate passing through the focus. Here you see that for every negative value of y, there will be two values of x which are equal in magnitude, opposite in sign. And again, when y tends towards minus infinity, when y tends towards minus infinity, y x increases infinitely and decreases infinitely. So that means one value of x will tend towards plus infinity, another value of x will tend towards minus infinity. That means the entire part of the curve x square is equal to minus 4ay will be lying in the third and fourth quadrant. The entire part of the curve x square is equal to minus 4ay will be lying in the third and the fourth quadrant. So here similarly, we can easily find out those 7 points of the curve x square is equal to minus 4ay, but by replacing a by minus a in the equation x square is equal to 4ay. So naturally, what will the equation of the vertex in this case? Vertex is equal to 0, 0. And what is the focus of this? X square is equal to minus 4y. It will be equal to 0 minus a. Because you have to replace a by minus a. And what will the endpoints of later septum? It is 2a minus a. It is minus 2a minus a. That means endpoints will be plus minus 2a minus a. It is the endpoints of the later septum of the parabola x square is equal to minus 4y. Now similarly, what will the length of the later septum? Length of the later septum is no doubt it is equal to 4a, 2a plus 2a, 4a. What is the equation of the directrix? You just replace a by minus a. So y is equal to a will be equal to directrix. Equation of the directrix is, in you replace a by minus a, so y is equal to a. That is the equation of the directrix. And again, equation of the axis, this is y axis is the axis of this parabola whose equation is x is equal to 0. Now again, on replacing a by minus a, we are getting the equation of the later septum. So this is the later septum. So later septum is nothing but y is equal to minus 4, y is equal to minus a. So these are the 7 points of the parabola x square is equal to minus 4ay. Thank you.